What's red and bad for your teeth? A brick. Hi everyone, welcome to the next episode of our Q&A series. My name is Maciek, I'm one of the leaders of Enxoo's industry practice, and in this series of videos I'm presenting our point of view on some topics related to the comms industry APification. I have announced today's episode almost 3 months ago, back in the episode number one, where I try to explain the differences between TM Forum and MEF. As you already know, MEF have their own LSO framework, which I explained in the episode number two. And to keep the balance, today we're going to take a look into the TM Forum garage. So, a question for today. ODA, what does this acronym mean? ODA, Open Digital Architecture, what it is? So let me try to explain that in brief. ODA, Open Digital Architecture, is a relatively new blueprint and reference framework created by TM Forum that is aimed to help communication service providers on their efforts to revolutionize their IT and network systems and evolve from the traditional telco into a truly digital service provider. Service providers are pressed to do that because it's a challenge for them to compete with so-called digital natives, you know, new companies coming from the software space like AWS, Microsoft, that are basically eating their cake. And the ODA program was launched in 2018, and one of the main ideas was to break the traditional view of the CSP IT systems landscape, you know, the one with monolithic, inflexible BSS and OSS silo, into more flexible, agile, component-based approach. Now, it's not my objective in this video to explain details and all the concepts of the ODA, because it's actually quite extensive and also very well explained by TM Forum in their materials. And if you'd like to learn more about it firsthand, under this episode, you can find several links that might be a good starting point. However, what I'd like to do in this episode, I'd like to share a few key takeaways that I find the most interesting and important. So the takeaway number one, ODA breaks the monolithic BSS OSS architectures into more modular, component-based approach. I perceive it as a TM Forum response to the whole microservice revolution that has started more than a decade ago. So the idea is pretty much the same. Instead of big, inflexible, monolithic systems, let's define smaller components, or so-called services, with clearly defined responsibility that are easier to manage and that encapsulate their functionality behind a standardized TM Forum Open API interface. So in this new approach, instead of one monolithic system that, you know, does everything from managing customer information, capturing orders, to generating customer bills, we might have separate components, services responsible for customer management, separate one for the product catalog management, separate one for order management, all of them communicating with each other with the use of standardized TM Forum Open APIs. Great idea. So, to the takeaway number two, new ODA functional blocks. ODA defines so-called functional blocks as logical groupings of these components that I mentioned in the point number one. And I wanted to bring it up because I think it's an interesting evolution of the traditional architecture layers that define business and operational layers, BSS and OSS. So in the ODA, at the highest level, we have five functional groupings: engagement management, party management, core commerce management, production, and intelligence management. And within each of those functional groupings, we'll have multiple components talking to each other. Actually, there is also a sixth functional block called decoupling and integration. And it's like a glue, keeping everything together. Now, what I find extremely interesting is that ODA clearly defines the character and responsibility of these components within each grouping, and it classifies them as systems of engagement that are responsible for providing multi-channel interactions, through front-ends or APIs. Then we have systems of records that are responsible for storing the data and for the actual execution of the business process. And we have systems of insights that are responsible for, aggregate data and providing business insights. And I believe this is quite an interesting concept because one of the promises of ODA is a greater flexibility. And with such a split of responsibility, what happens is related to my takeaway number three, which is the attempt to move the old digital boundary between systems of engagement and systems of record. In the traditional monolithic architectures, it was frequently very difficult to compose solutions fitted to the expected customer experience. And with the new approach and composable and reusable services, there is a promise to be able to do it much easier. What it means in practice is that we might have multiple components in the engagement layer, multiple customer portals, maybe mobile application, a front end for customer service agents, as well as the self-service API for enterprise use cases. And they all might require to feed the data from the system of records in a different manner. And the ODA approach promises such flexibility and composability. Apart from these three takeaways, I would also like to mention that ODA proposes modern software architectural principles with cloud-native, open standard-based approach. So it's pushing many vendors to navigate into that direction. And we've also seen ODA topic as an important one on the agenda for many service providers, enabling them to increase flexibility and reduce costs of software development and maintenance. I hope you like this not as brief explanation, but as I said at the beginning, there are supporting links to supporting materials under this video on our enxoo.com website. Join our newsletter and subscribe to our channel if you'd like to get notified about new episodes of our Q&A series. And if you'd like to learn more or get some help with your systems architecture design following frameworks like ODA or LSO, I wanted to announce that we're launching a free expert consultation services where you can get opportunity to meet with one of our consulting experts to discuss your challenges or the questions you might have. So if you'd be interested, book it today through our website. Thank you for watching. Cheers.